Hello everyone, welcome back to this ongoing lecture series on steps to do clinical research in the proper way. I thought I'll share my story with you and let's see whether it could be yours. So I've been through a lot of rigorous residency programs in India as well as abroad, as well as fellowship training programs where you are working from 9 to 9, almost 12 hours a day on these programs and don't really have the time or the space rather in your 24 hours to fill in and do some positive clinical research. So let me share my story with you, and again, like I said, let's see if it could be your story. So to begin with, my early grooming or my initial training or exposure to research was during my MBBS days, where I did my MBBS from Krishna Institute of Medical Sciences in Karad, and that was a place which actually exposed me to initial clinical research. It wasn't very huge, it was between the third and the fourth years of medicine, and what I really got exposed to were certain small-scaled ICMR projects. They were funded by ICMR, and what I really had to do was basically take a survey questionnaire, go to a village and go from door to door and get answers to these questionnaires. And that really exposed me to data, to how data is collected, how data is organized, how data is made sense of, and then how data is published. And so that really got me excited about this whole concept that this is something in parallel that we need to think about. So that got me thinking in terms of doing something parallel in addition to medicine, and that this is something that is important and that we need to pay more attention to. So I did not have any publications when I finished my MBBS, but that seed or the inception of the idea had already crept up. Then I went to Chitmar, that is Jawaharlal Institute of Postgraduate Medical Education and Research in Pondicherry, and that is when I took my first baby steps into clinical research. And during my diploma of 2 years, I was successful in publishing 5 papers in Indian and international journals. And the first, I'll tell you what I did for my first publication. I basically rounded off all the references, got full texts of those references, and helped my mentors, who are now my mentors, I helped them write the paper. So looked at all these publications, so 7 or 8 full text references, highlighted certain points that might be of use to write the paper, and I saw them write the paper. And gradually that is how, step by step, taking baby steps, I graduated on. Then I went to Arvind Eye Hospital in Pondicherry, and that is where I took major strides in research. I found good mentors to help me, and during my 2.5 years of doing my diplomate in National Board in Ophthalmology, I was successful in publishing about 18 papers. And I'm sure if you have heard about Arvind Eye Hospital Pondicherry, or in general the Arvind Eye Care Systems, you would know that in a day the hospital see more than 1,000 patients almost every day, and that is a very very rigorous way of learning clinical ophthalmology. Yes, but then I also managed to publish 18 papers, and somehow I used to go to the medical records department at about 6 in the evening, get some case sheets, and just give like 45 minutes almost on a daily basis. So I spent 45 minutes every day in the medical records and filled about 5 or 6 patient data on the Excel sheet, and that's about it. And then I interacted with statisticians at the Arvind Systems, and then I started writing papers. If you see, the building blocks were those 45 minutes on a daily basis, and that really was it. Then I went to Shankar Netralaya, the best place for learning vitreoretinal surgery and fellowship. I pursued a 2.5 year clinical cum research fellowship, and that is where I took concrete research training steps. And I had the opportunity to work with Dr. Rajiv Raman there, and that really gave me a lot of concrete ideas on how to go about and do clinical research. And I knew that if I spent 45 minutes on a daily basis, I will be able to build it up step by step again and then create papers. And that's how in 2.5 years time, I was successful in publishing 12 papers from Shankar Netralaya. So that was a very, very positive experience. So by the time I had finished fellowship, I had roughly 35 publications to my name. And remember that I spent about 45 minutes on a daily basis, not more, not less. And because of my publication track record, I was successful in getting a research or a postdoctoral research fellowship at the Wilmer Eye Institute at Johns Hopkins University. So at Wilmer, I spent about 15 months, and I did specialized training in research methodology, in biostatistics, in grant craft, in how do you set up a clinical trial, how do you you know, make sense of all this data. I was fortunate enough to get exposed to the AREDS study, which was like a 10-year follow-up data of more than 10,000 patients, and I saw those statisticians really doing those studies and getting the best data out, and that was a very, very positive experience for me. And at Wilmer, I was successful in publishing about 6 papers there. So gradually, as you can see, spending 45 minutes on a daily basis, even if you say you spend 45 minutes, you know, once in 2 days, that is what really gets you to doing good clinical research and then learning. So that is generally my story of how I managed to publish papers on a very regular basis, even during, you know, rigorous residency programs. I would put it down to, you know, first point being sufficient motivation. So according to Harvard Business Review, the two main causes of bad decisions are insufficient motivation and cognitive, that is thinking bias, thinking that I'll not be able to do it. And then, of course, insufficient motivation. So these are some things which I got over. Then have a growth mindset and not a fixed mindset. Be eager to learn with an open mind, accept criticism to make and to see the larger picture. Then learn by observation, learn by deliberate practice, and learn by breaking it down. So you have to practice, you have to do this over and over again, like any other skill that you learn, like surgery or like reading an ECG, for example. You need to keep doing this over and over again. And then break it down. So it's large skills need to be broken down into steps. So you need to learn the steps of doing proper research. And then last but not the least, find the right teacher. A bad teacher can set you back years. So you need to find a mentor, which I was very, like I said, I was very fortunate to have mentors. And so that's my story. And like I said, I'm hoping that it could be yours, and that you will go along and do a lot of good things and write good papers. Thank you.